Thank you. Ah, Brother Luther, not a moment too soon. As you have noticed, dread things inhabit this place. Shambling corpses, and worse.
There is darkness at work here, in the midst of the Inquisition.
I suspect it is worse than that, but I have no proof. Brother Andrew knew this also, and paid the price for it.
Why are you telling me this?
Perhaps you can finish off what Andrew started. Take this key. It unlocks the old tower. It has been sealed off since the Inquisition arrived.
I intend to uncover the truth behind this.
If you manage to uncover the source of darkness, return here. I will do everything I can to help. Till then, brother, may your faith protect you.
Anymore.
Don't be so weak, Alex. You have a stronger mind than this. I didn't bring up a weakling. Not a scared wretch of a girl.
You kept all this from me. You You kept me alone. You shared nothing with me.
I couldn't. I could never give you the burden. I just wanted you to grow up. To grow up and leave me alone. Why couldn't you have been killed with your parents?
This can't be happening!
Charlemagne.
Thank you.
Brother Andrew suspected Augustine all along. I managed to find remnants of his journal, and it all points to Augustine's involvement with a paganistic cult operating inside the cathedral.
Aye, the cathedral's dark secret has been uncovered. I too suspected this, but was too afraid to act. Augustine himself is a heretic.
He has covered his tracks well, claiming that the sacred relic, the Hand of Jude, was stored here. He had those who came to see it murdered. The Hand of Jude never existed.
And with that realization, the trap closes, brother. My days here are numbered. I awoke to find this cruel dagger placed upon my pillow this morn. It can only mean one thing. I know too much, and they are moving to silence me. I can only hope that what little faith I have left is enough to save my soul. Please, take this thing away from me. Its very sight troubles me to no end. May your faith protect thee, Brother Luther, for that's all you have.
Thank you.
You are a clever man, Brother Luther. Wanting answers to clarify your new position as fugitive, you seek them out, and this is what you find. Tell me, what does a man such as yourself think of when he finds a viper's nest of heresy? When he finds the very source of corruption?
I think of irony. Irony of what you, masquerading as a member of the Inquisition, stand for. And that you stand for evil.
Evil is merely a perspective which no longer concerns me, Luther. You will be executed in the most painful manner imaginable. After we have broken your frail body and mind in the name of our true Lord, Zelototh! Come, my children. Feast on this morsel and let us return to our preparations. Your task, my liege and greater guardian, is to guard this place. Do not worry about this worm. His kind yelps in terror at the sight of your mightiness. We will dispose of him ourselves.
If I am to guard this place,
is coming.
Who are you?
I am your lord and conqueror.
What manner of forsaken being are you?
So, you can see me in my true form. You are a gifted man. Take this one and use him as the foundation for the pillar. He is special and should be given a special place among the suffering.
Much has been written about the exploits of conquerors. In the context of history, one man's champion is another man's nemesis, hero or murderer. Much has been written, but what has not is far more interesting. The Tome of Eternal Darkness mentions a Venetian artist and architect of the Renaissance named Roberto Bianchi. Roaming abroad to find inspiration, he was captured by a warlord expanding his empire. He forced Roberto to use his architectural and engineering skills to construct a monument to his greatness. To complete his task, he must survey the site.
Survey the site quickly, dog, and maybe you'll live long enough to see the sacrament's construction. Did you think we would trust you, Bianchi? Even though you are graced with the generosity of our liege, you are still his prisoner. As I said, finish your work quickly. And maybe we'll drag you out of this hole.